Hello and welcome to your daily news and information update. Today's topic, unemployment despair. Edmund Phelps, a professor at Columbia University and 2006 winner of the Nobel Prize in Economics, recently told Bloomberg News that America will have to deal with permanent unemployment increases in the future. The typical unemployment rate in the United States had been reported at around 5.5% in 2006. According to Phelps, we should now expect that number to be at or around 7% in the future, even in the best of times. That equates to tens of millions of Americans on the street without any hope for employment prospects. Our economy has officially stumbled over an obstacle to the point where it cannot right itself again. There is very little reason to believe there will be another revolution of technology based solely in the United States, similar to the computer and internet breakthroughs of the past two decades. Furthermore, there is even less reason to believe that this country will be able to revamp the financial industry to grow upon the workforce which it has already shed. In short, this country is in serious trouble. Our president has promised to create or save 3 to 4 million jobs during his first term. Unfortunately, this economy is on pace to lose over 7 million jobs in 2009 alone. When that's drawn out over the full term in office, this country could see unemployment increase by 20 million people in the next 4 years, with or without government intervention. The American economy is exhausted. After abandoning industry for high technology and finance, we have officially eaten up all of the runway in front of us, all the while failing to take off. In the meantime, other countries around the world, particularly Japan, India, and China, have focused on building robust manufacturing industries while simultaneously building up technological and financial sectors. U.S. economic policy was narrow-minded. It put all its eggs in one basket, and now it's paying the price. The only way for this economy to survive and thrive in the future is to focus on manufacturing and industry. We need to take the money being given to insolvent and poorly managed banks and give it to American manufacturers. We need to help American auto companies stay afloat and give them the tools to refurbish themselves for the future, instead of stomping on them and forsaking the millions who depend on the big three for employment. This country needs a new approach if it hopes to ever save this economy. Even if we do these things, we have likely been irrevocably replaced by China, Japan, the European Union, and eventually India as economic powers in this world. On behalf of Concerned Citizens, I'm Craig Harrington. For more on this and other related topics, please log on to economyandcrisis.org.
Wake up, America! Open up your eyes! Wake up, America! Wake up!